Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. My name is Shami Sajwani and you are watching Upskill Yourself. In today's video, we'll be discussing the future of web development, what I think the web development world would look like after a few years, and because of the advancement of new platforms like WordPress and Wix and many other, and no doubt these are some amazing platforms and easy to learn and easy to work with. And with that coming and growing so quickly, the main question that arrives is HTML and CSS still required? Should a person still consider learning HTML and CSS when there are other platforms available to you? So in this video, I'll be sharing the pros and cons of both HTML, CSS and WordPress. And I'm going to put all the points in front of you so that you can decide what suits your needs and what path should you take then. I also have made some videos in the past teaching you some amazing CSS tricks. So if you want to check them out, I'll have them linked in the description and also in the iCard. And so if you find the video informative, drop a like to it, comment and share as it really helps me a lot, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And without further ado, let's get into the video. All right. So let's discuss about these platforms first. So if you're a complete beginner and you don't know much about these platforms, so you can have a fair bit of idea what you're getting into. So WordPress was founded in May 27, 2003, and it powers many big websites for many big companies. This is a completely free tool where you can design your website in a drag and drop manner, and you don't need any programming knowledge about it. So anyone can take advantage from it. And what type of websites you can build, you might ask. Using WordPress, you can build websites for businesses, e-commerce website, blogs, portfolio, resumes, forums, and social networking sites. And anything you would want to and you can think of and you can build using HTML and CSS, that can be pretty much done everything using WordPress. So there are mainly two different types of WordPress. One is WordPress.com and one is WordPress.org. Now let's talk about the real OGs, HTML and CSS. HTML was first initially discovered and founded by Tim Berners-Lee in 1980. And then after a few years in 1994, CSS was introduced by Hakeem Weomley. HTML is responsible for the content of the website, like all the structure of the website. And CSS is responsible for the design and layout of the website, like all the colors, the fonts, the shapes and everything. The placement of each object is done using CSS. So CSS is kind of a very powerful tool because it helps you elevate your website. You can change the entire feel and look of your website using CSS. And the main problem with that is that they need to be coded, HTML and CSS, and you need to learn both of these languages. So, with the introduction out of the way, now let's talk about the pros and cons of these two things. So WordPress being an easy platform saves you from the learning to code in different languages, right? Because it is a easy and free tool which you can download on your system and you can start building from it. And it is a drag and drop manner, so you can drag this position and place it over here. You can drag this box, place it over there. You can design and make it look as you want it. And you don't need any coding experience or any coding background. You can simply start right away. You can just go right now to WordPress and you can start building your own website. And also, if your client is okay with it, then start using these platforms. So first get it straight with your client that if your client wants you to make a website using WordPress or Wix, because a lot of times clients want something to be made entirely from scratch with their own thinking in mind because they have something thought of for their business or their brand. So you need to first contact them and first clarify with them that, are you okay with me using WordPress or Wix to make your website? Using HTML and CSS, you can build your website from scratch and have your own base to it. You can add more features to it. You can do what you want to and how you want to, and you will not be limited by any of the features, right? And in HTML and CSS, you can have your own themes and design and feel to your website. This is where HTML and CSS gets a point in my books. But also on the other hand, this is time consuming, right? Because building everything from scratch and placing everything and learning everything is going to be very time consuming. So you might want to jump to WordPress for doing that, because using WordPress, you can build a website in less than an hour. Like, I'm not even kidding. You can go over to YouTube. You have so many tutorials on how to do it, and you can start building right away, and you will be done in less than an hour. And the most important point, which is most overlooked, is that you don't have any control over your website's data, and which is the most important thing, I believe, because a user coming to your website is trusting you with their data, and if they're putting in their credentials and everything, they will expect that it stays safe and private, right? Using WordPress or Wix or any of these platforms, you don't know where your data is actually going, right? You are using the database, but you don't actually know where the data is, and you don't have control over it. On the other hand, if you're making it using HTML and CSS, you will be learning MySQL, and you will be learning SQL servers, and then you will be knowing your data is in your control on your local servers, because a user's data is very important, especially in an e-commerce website. And if anything goes south, you might end up losing all the data. And if you have it locally stored on your system using the database, you will know where your data is going, and you will have safe with you. All right. So in my opinion, I think WordPress is better for a vast majority, because nowadays the world is moving very fast, and every small business and every small startup is looking for a website, because everyone needs to shift online, right? Because you cannot have things offline now. And with that advancement of these platforms like WordPress, Wix, Shopify, you can make your websites on your own, and you can start your business right away. And this is something very good, because you don't need any programming background for it. Anyone can start anytime and anywhere. They already have a lot of themes available to you, a lot of features available to you, and you can take most advantage from it. However, I also feel like HTML and CSS are there to stay for a good amount of years. Because no matter how many themes and features they introduce, they won't be able to compare that with the comfortability and controllability you get out of coding something on your own, right? You get a sense of satisfaction that you're able to do this on your own. You're learning a new skill. And also, at the same time, you have control over everything, which is exactly what I would be preferring if I was making my website. So if you're a beginner, then you can use WordPress and Wix and get a website of your own built and started, and then learn from it. And if you're already into computer science, and if you want to learn how all of these things are happening on the back end, and you want to learn and build on your own, then you can learn HTML and CSS as well. These are not very difficult languages, and these are very simple to get a hold on and to learn. I also was able to learn HTML and CSS in 3 months, so it won't take much of your time as well. And I've put all of these points in front of you so that now you can make a decision on your own where you want to go, right? If you want to take WordPress, if you want to take HTML and CSS route, you can do that as well. And if you have any questions still, and if you're stuck anywhere in between, and if you want to know anything about these platforms in more depth, let me know in the comments below. DM me on my Instagram. I always reply there as well. As always, please like the video if you find it informative. Comment what you like the most about it, share it with your friends, help each other out, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye bye.